Yeah, this Indian Sociological Society, it was established in 1951. Till date, it is the only association of professional sociologists in India, and it has more than 3,500 members. There are student members as well as teachers who are members of this association, and almost annually it has organized conferences in different places. Universities have hosted conferences for the association. While it was established in 51, JNU is holding the 37th annual conference for All India Conference for Indian Sociological Society, and it's an honor both for JNU and for Indian Sociological Society that this conference is being organized, and it's the Diamond Jubilee year of the Indian Sociological Society, and that makes both JNU and Indian Sociological Society organizing this conference a special event. The Vice President of India, His Excellency Shri Mohammad Hamid Ansari, is going to inaugurate this, and there are going to be a few sociologists from International Sociological Society who are also coming, and they're going to speak and address to the students and teachers and members of the Indian Sociological Society here, and spend time, interact with students and faculty and members of the Indian Sociological Society. So it's a great event. Besides this, there's something very interesting that has happened following the Golden Jubilee series. There is a 7 edited volumes that are coming out as part of the Diamond Jubilee celebrations, which Sage Publications is bringing out. They have published it, and those will also be released by the Vice President. The journal of the Indian Sociological Society called Sociological Bulletin is a regular journal which has been published since 1952. And there will be a release of this bulletin's issue, which is the Diamond Jubilee issue, and it's a special issue that looks at the history of the Indian Sociological Society and the journey of the Sociological Bulletin, which is being negotiated with JSTOR so that it could go to JSTOR and be available globally as an electronic data source and resource for referencing. So in that sense, the bulletin, the Indian Sociological Society and JNU all are coming together to make sociology more widespread and get a greater interaction between the young sociologists who are students, volunteers from different universities across the country, and even from other South Asian countries. There are members who have decided to come to this conference. So it is really going to be a confluence of ideas, and these ideas would generate a lot more in terms of what are the kinds of crises that Indian society is going through these days in terms of the various shades, preferences, issues like transformation, marginalization, globalization, governance are the ones that are centrally going to be addressed in this conference. And this is what Indian society is actually going through these days, whether it is FDIs or food crisis or food inflation, employment or software industry where it is doing very well, or the global recession which is affecting the European and the North American regions of the world, and how that would impact India, what kind of governance and political issues are involved, what kind of social issues and implications these can have. Sociologically, trying to look at some of these issues would be the primary concern of this conference, and I'm sure the kind of work JNU is doing towards this conference, it will be a great success, and it will also generate a lot of ideas about how sociologists reflect upon many of these questions which affect our day-to-day lives as Indians, as young as well as old, as professionals as well as ordinary citizens of this country.